Artificial intelligence can do so many things, from writing cover letters to mashing up art from your favorite movies. And as fascinating as AI is, it's also a source of fear for many people.
What is this place?
Are you real?
Well, if you can't tell, does it matter?
There's uncertainty around what it will mean for the future of many jobs.
The mechanical monster!
And there's even the fear that AI will become sentient and take over society as a whole.
That, I think, is not so much of a concern because nature has already really perfected ways of causing death and destruction on a very large scale.
What if AI could save the planet instead?
In the case of AI for protein design, the benefits far outweigh the risks. The proteins we're designing are to solve modern day problems, and with AI letting us solve them more readily, that is pure positive.
At the University of Washington, researchers are working to develop new medicines and treatments on ways to break down plastics in our oceans and on other projects that aim to solve many of our everyday human problems. All doing this on a much faster and condensed scale than previously dreamt of, thanks to AI.
In this video, you're going to see the future.
All of this can be fed into the computer.
Since the invention of the computer, scientists have been trying to harness this technology to design new proteins.
Proteins are the miniature machines that carry out all the important functions in our bodies.
The protein itself, you can imagine, is a tiny string that's tangled up in a certain very specific orientation.
The tangling of that string is a process called folding.
I understand that, but how do you fold it?
That folded shape is essentially the basis of life, making almost everything in the natural world what it is. It's what makes a banana taste sweet. It's what tells your body to have blue or brown eyes. And it's how your body recognizes and defends against threats like colds and other viruses. So how do scientists even know how to find and make the right proteins to do the jobs that they need them to do?
All the possible combinations you can imagine to make that protein are greater than the number of atoms in the universe. Not an infinite, but a close to infinite amount of possible proteins. And so this is the problem. You have many different possible combinations, and you're looking for just a few that are correct in this giant sea of possibilities.
With computers, scientists would still have to spend months sifting through the thousands of options before eventually hitting the protein jackpot. Let's break down how AI, and specifically a type of AI called diffusion models, brings us everything from dubs in a Wes Anderson movie to new ways of eliminating plastics from our oceans. With applications like DALL-E and Midjourney, diffusion models can generate new images. Instead of analyzing just one image, diffusion models learn the underlying patterns that make up an image by learning to find true images in heavily corrupted inputs. And now we can make diffusion models not just for images, but for proteins as well.
So deep learning basically involves taking a very large set of data and solving problems by looking for recurrent patterns.
Diffusion models are this quite new area of artificial intelligence. They're really, really good at making new things. We don't have to decide or define what the shape of our binding protein will be. We can just ask the neural network to bind to this protein that we want to bind, and it will come up with the shape on its own.
The AI learns everything it can about an image. If it's looking at a picture of a cat, it learns the structures that make up the nose, the patterns that make up the fur, the shape of the tail, and the placement of the feet, and then processes that information. Then, it uses what it has learned to recreate a brand new image when prompted. And the same concept applies when looking at how we design new proteins.
So the way we think about doing this is that we take those known proteins that we know exist in nature, and we present these to artificial intelligence, or a neural network as we call it. We ask the neural network to essentially learn from those proteins such that we can then have it generate brand new ones which follow the same patterns and have the same properties of proteins that exist in nature.
A neural network is a type of computer program that is inspired by the way that our brains work. Just like our brains have millions of interconnected neurons that work together to process information, a neural network is made of small, relatively simple computing units that collectively are able to solve a complex problem, which is why it has been such a game changer for scientists racing to find cures and new technologies.
The change in using deep learning methods is that has become a lot faster, because now you're not asking what are the tiny minuscule difference between these two very similar things. You can go ahead and in a single step ask how likely is this overall protein fold to be.
And once we have done this, our diffusion model is now able to very rapidly just make a whole range of brand new proteins that have never existed in nature.
So they offer all kinds of new possibilities, because now you can go beyond what you've been provided with the natural protein universe.
Now that we can use AI to help us discover not only proteins in the natural world to solve our problems, but can also create previously undiscovered proteins to solve even more problems, the task for humans has shifted.
There's still a big role for scientists in this process. It's the scientists who work out what problems we need to work on and how they might be solved. And then artificial intelligence is just being used as a tool here.
It's become much more straightforward to cast your ideas, so your dreams of what the protein should look like, into a design. And then at the same time, it's also become simpler to test those in the lab. And the whole design cycle is much improved now, in the sense that you can now maybe tackle much more difficult problems.
Recently, we've been able to do things that were previously unimaginable. And this is really because of artificial intelligence and the application of AI to protein design.
I think we're now in the midst of a protein design revolution. And as this becomes more and more mature, I think the worldwide impacts are going to get larger and larger.